Hi, and welcome back to another video with Math Skills to Ace Chemistry. We're going to be going over how to round sig figs, meaning that if we are doing all these different calculations or measurements and all this different mathematics when it comes to chemistry, we need to make sure we are representing our values with the correct amount of significance. Meaning that if you're doing an experiment, and let's say if you take one measurement with a beaker, you take another one with like a graduated cylinder, or so different piece of glassware, and then you do another one with a $50,000 piece of chemical instrumentation. Well, some of those are pretty accurate. One of them you're paying a lot of money for. So, but if you use like a beaker, let's say, to measure the amount of liquid you put into the instrument in the beginning, well, that might not be, it might set off your values possibly, or who knows, depending on how you did the experiment, there's a possibility that it's not completely showing the correct amount of significance. So we need to make sure that when we do chemical calculations, we are representing it by whatever we shirked off the most on. So if you were kind of lazy on one part of it, well, sadly, you got to represent all your numbers based on that value. So let's take a look at it. Let's try to see what this is all about. So if I have the following example, so if I have the following number, it's 26.542. And if we wanted to kind of label all these different numbers here, well, remember, just kind of review our places of a decimal. Usually this is what we're typically rounding most of the time in chemistry, is the decimal place. Where do you want to put it? Well, if we're looking at these, sometimes we're going to be seeing different labels, which maybe you remember from high school, maybe you don't, and that's okay too. That's why we're going over it. So these are the 10th place, the 100th place, the 1000th place. So that little th just tells you it's after the decimal. So it's what is the first, second, or third position tells you what you might have to round it to. So if you're using a piece of glassware that only goes to the 100th position, well, then you need to round it correctly and cut off numbers. So what you're going to be doing is when you're rounding, you always look to the digit on the right. So let's say, for example, if I ask you to round to the 10th position here. So rounding right in here. And let's clean that up for a second. So if I tell you right here, the 10th spot is what we're going to be rounding. Well, how would we do that? Well, the whole idea when it comes to rounding is you look to the digit on the right, meaning that when we are doing this, we want to stick a big underline right under a 5, and then we're going to be looking at the 4 value next door. Now, when we're doing that, what do you do? Well, if the digit is 0 to 4, you round down. So meaning whatever's on the right, you round down, meaning you keep your 5 at what it is. If the digit to the right is 5 or 9, you're going to round up. So in this case, looking at this, well, 5 was next to 4, meaning that we round down. So when we do this, we keep it at its number. We don't round it up. So in this case, what would it be? Well, it's going to be 26.5 is going to be our final number in this situation, because we had a 4 next to it. You want the lower value to represent that. Now, if I take the same number and I ask you, okay, well, why don't you try to round to the nearest 100th place, which is this second spot? Well, same situation here. We look over, we look one to the right. We could see, well, it's 0 to 4. Okay, so that's telling you, all right, we got to round down again. So how would we show that value? Well, it would be 26.54 would be our number. And this tells you how many significant figures you have, right? So we rounded it to show 4 sig figs, which might be how many is a very common amount you need for a lot of chemical calculations. If I asked you another example, what if I asked you to give you the other half? If I asked you round it to the 10 or the tens position, or not tens, but the ones position, sorry. And if you were to do that, well, you're going to once again look over to the right and you see, oh, this is greater than 5. So you're going to, in this case, round up. So what instead is that 6 is going to go up and become a 7. So that would make it 27. So these are some of the different ways you can round. So, and you can see how many different number of sig figs that you have in each of these rounding scenarios. So this is why it's really important, because you want to represent however many sig figs are appropriate for your current situation. So let's practice this again to wrap up the video. So round each number to the underlined digit and determine the number of significant figures. Okay, so let's do it. If we look at the first one, we have 4. We're going to look to the right, and we see that we have 332.452. The 5 is up there, so 5 through 9, you round up. So in this case, what are we going to have? We're going to make 332.5 is going to be our number, because that 4 rounds up. And if we want to count sig figs, this would be a total of 4 non-zero digits. So we have 4 significant figures in our calculation. Now, let's do the next one. So we have 8,802.14. Great. However, we want to round that number. So by doing this, we can look over and we can see, all right, well, we can look to the right. We see that it's 2, meaning that it's from 0 to 4. You round down. So in this case, how are we going to show this? Well, this one's a little weird, because if we round down, do we drop things and get rid of it? No, we need to make sure we're still showing the correct number of placeholders in our calculation. It still has to show the same general size of the value. So when we do this, we have 8,800 would be our value. And notice that it still shows that same value. We don't drop the 0. We don't just drop it as it is. A common error that I see a lot of students do is that in this case, you might have wrote 880 and think, I'm good. But the thing is, think of it in this light, and you probably won't do this mistake again. Let's think of this all in terms of money. People never forget money. Let's say someone owed you $8,800. And they're like, oh, I rounded it, and here's $880 because I dropped that significant figure. You would not be very happy about that, right? To get paid a tenth of what you're supposed to get paid, right? So you still want to show the same size of value that it's supposed to be. So that's the whole idea, right? It shows what is the right place or size. So when we look at this, we only have 2 significant figures, because in this case, there's no decimal, so the trailing zeros are not significant. So when we round it, it gets rid of the decimal when you round it in the middle of the big side of these numbers. Okay, now the next one, I have 35,402. Same idea, right? We have 5, and we want to look over, and we're going to be rounding down. So we're going to have 3,500 is going to be our answer here. And we only have 2 significant figures because the trailing zeros are not significant. Now the next one, oh, what the heck is that? Well, this is scientific notation. This is going to be the next video. So scientific notation is a very easy way to kind of minimize or to make smaller lot really big numbers or really, really small numbers. But the cool thing about scientific notation is the numbers that are in front of that multiplication symbol are the only numbers that represent any significant digits. So before rounding, just to kind of let you know, there are 4 sig figs currently in this number. We don't count the times 10 to the fifth. That's just telling you how much you're moving a decimal when you or want to show this in its numeric or standard form. So we want to round it. We could leave it in this form, which is awesome. So you take that 0, you look over at the 7, and we see that, okay, well, it's going to round up. So in this case, we'll have 1.31, and we have our number of sig figs there. So this tells you you have 1, 2, 3 sig figs. And we can't forget to bring down the times 10 to the fifth. Now, this is scientific notation form. What this tells you is eventually what we're going to go over in the next video is how you can show it in standard form. All right. This is how you can count and round different examples. So hopefully this helps with your future homework assignments and to help you in your chemistry course. Says Dr. Dan here, please hit that like and subscribe button. Hit comment below if you have any questions or if you need help or have any future videos you'd love to see. All right, thank you so much, and I'll see you all soon. Bye now.